I was a lucky boy for my birthday. Guess what I got?
I know.
So there really is typically just a piece or two, like a serious piece of kit that keeps you away from a whole genre of work. Mine being metalwork. I have a welder, I have drills to be able to drill it, I have a drill press. I've got nothing really to kind of cut it. And I've wanted a bandsaw for a very long time. And I got one. Awesome. Got a little demonstration for you. I don't mind if I do. I just found some nice steel tubing. I'm going to clamp this to the bench, to the workbench. Brilliant. Wait until you see the things that I'm going to start building. You know, it's not super heavy. I think it's about 7 pounds. You got easy access. This door flips open, and then you're able to. You got the blade tensioner here. When you kind of unlatch it, the top wheel kind of comes down, and then you're able to push fit the blade on. I haven't looked to see if there's various types of saw blade yet. I can only imagine that there must be. But very solid, even though a lot of it is like plastic, the parts that count are metal and very rigid in the way that they're put together. So I love it. It didn't come with a battery. It did not come with a charger, and don't buy that from Home Depot. Go to Amazon, and you'll save yourself $100. So I got the battery and the charger for $150. Actually, how much did I spend now? I cannot remember for the life of me. I'll put it in the description below. But yeah. Over the moon, probably one of the best purchases I've bought in a very long time, just for how much that I will end up using this with the future builds, especially on my YouTube channel. I like it. It's got a good solid like two-hand feel to it. The blade is off-center, so the blade is here and you're gripping it here, and the blade is over, so it's kind of off-center, but it's very easy, very intuitive to hold. It's very, ergonomic. I think that's the right word. And yeah, I'm loving it, absolutely loving it. So I'm gonna make a little stand for it, like a little table bandsaw, albeit not massive capacity, but big enough to do all the jobs that I need to do. Quite honestly. So yeah, excited to see what projects that I end up doing this year with my new Makita handheld bandsaw.
Who knew I'd even say such words?
You know, as far as packaging, Makita are as far from Apple. If you open up like an Apple product, albeit yes, they're known for their packaging, and not a good comparison at all. But you know, this is as far away from that type of packaging as you can get. All that was in here was this bit of cardboard, and then that's it. There was nothing else. The charger wasn't in here, so I'm going to take that out. Show you that in a minute. It just had the blade, plastic bag, warranty and instructions, and that was it. Just that's all that came in the box. Enough so that I felt like, well, the charger could have gone in here, I believe. I felt that they just decided to make one type of box, and they would ship some out with the bandsaw, the handheld bandsaw, without the charger, and then some with. But then obviously, if you got with, then you're gonna be paying the extra price. It kind of, what I've been noticing lately is I've been going to Home Depot, and I've been noticing that the prices are being saying one thing, and when you get to the checkout, it's something else altogether. And they kind of sucker you in with some sort of almost like false advertising, in a sense. I know that's a strong thing to say, but I've not been happy. The last two or three purchases that I've made at Home Depot, I have actually ended up paying a lot more. And I get outside and I'm like, what did I just buy? And I know that the label clearly said, you know, X amount, and I get out there, just buyer beware, you know, look up. I'm just an idiot at checking prices sometimes before I get to the checkout. But that's all right, I didn't buy this, but I would have. But my next major purchase is going to be a very serious piece of kit. A lot more than this costs. Although, the tool is in fact smaller than this, but not by much.
Bet you can't wait to find out what that is, can you? Eh?
So what I'm buying is a handheld CNC router. You put very cheap tape on your material, you scan it, and it digitizes it, and then it places your design that you designed on your computer onto the wood or the metal or the plastic, whatever it is that you're cutting. And we are just beyond excited to get our hands on this device. We had a little business some years ago that we want to be able to kick back up. We feel that this handheld CNC router is going to be the trick to getting some of the productivity out that was kind of lacking before. So this is going to open up so many doors. I want to do a lot of the framing and what have you with the boats with this. Initially I'm building some single man boats, but my next boat is going to be a two person boat that both D and I will be able to go out on the water and enjoy ourselves with. Anyway, so this is it. This is what I'm getting. The handheld CNC router. It's the Shaper Origin, made by ShaperTools.com. Next, I go through and I grab the polyacrylic and I filter it for any bits. I have a good cleanup in the garage, and I put a layer of the polyacrylic on the countertop. This is the very last touch for the actual countertop itself. I let it dry, and I go over it with a razor blade, just like I did the drawers, to remove any dust, any hair. And then I just give it a very light cleaning with some wire wool to take off any of the shiny spots or the dull spots, just to give it a beautiful even finish. I'm just tipping the edge here just to get rid of any of the air bubbles, and that's it. It has a beautiful nice thick coat